Coming to you from our GIS studios, I am Anicia Antoine, and this is your Midday News Brief. The Prime Minister of St. Lucia, Honourable Allen Chastanet, joined the Governor-General of St. Lucia, Sir Emmanuel Neville Cenac, as he opened up the Government House to the Rising Stars Police Youth Club, who have been engaged in a summer program with kids from the South. The Prime Minister commended members of the club and the RSLPF Beaufort Community Relations Branch, who devoted their valued time and efforts to making sure the children had fun while learning during the summer. Honourable Chastanet congratulated the police and the Rising Stars Youth Club on continuing to encourage the youth and building on relationships with the community. With the prediction of more intense weather systems as a result of climate change, the world must make the necessary adjustments so as to withstand the impacts. Prime Minister of St. Lucia, the Honourable Allen Chastanet, explained that the Government of St. Lucia has recognised that change is necessary, including a change in the public's mindset and behaviour in the face of climate change. Efforts must also be made to ensure that the country is more resilient, and that will require a change in the way it builds its infrastructure, among other things. Honourable Chastanet noted that there was to be the establishment of a $100 billion fund, however, it never got off the ground. The Prime Minister added that there must be a review as to the amount of time it takes to draw down on funds made available, as most of them have long project cycles. The Honourable Chastanet also indicated that a review of the classification of debt is a must. Debt incurred as a result of a country's thrust to build resilience or to rebuild after a disaster added to national debt is not sustainable, and repayment of such debts will require long periods. The Department of Health and Wellness wishes to inform the public that the Moshi and Tiroshe Castries Wellness Centres have been closed for retrofitting works under the Smart Healthcare Facilities Project Geared Towards Safer, Greener and More Sustainable Facilities. Residents of Moshi and Tiroshe Castries are kindly asked to access healthcare services at any other wellness centres in close proximity. The Entrepot and Library Wellness Centres will also be closed by the end of the first week in September to undergo similar retrofitting works. As of Monday, August 26, 2019, the Bexar Wellness Centre has been reopened for healthcare services to residents of the community. The Department of Health and Wellness wishes to thank the general public, especially those from the affected areas, for their continued cooperation during the Smart Healthcare Facilities project. This has been your Midday News Brief. Thank you for watching.